Members of Parliament on the ad hoc committee, which probes Naguru Nakawa land mystery today, grilled the Minister of State for Housing, Persis Namuganza, over her role in the allocation of the contested land after examining letters she had written to the commission asking them to allocate land to some companies.
Me to bring it to your attention about this land. No, give us where you base to submit Seven Hills and anneal the money. And for your information, even Seven Hills denied signing this letter. He actually had no knowledge of that letter, implying that letters were being generated by somewhere within your office. It may not be you, but somebody within.
Tara.
I didn't say you.
Very bad.
I think let's address the committee
now. It's very bad.
I am not saying you.
If you just start defaming your colleague like that, letters are being generated in my office.
Within the ministry, may not be you.
How?
But if Mr. Ali Damani, Anil Damani, denies having written this letter.
But who is Anil? Is he a criminal? I want to know also, because now Anil has become. Is Anil a criminal?
We are looking at
what?
How to talk. Let's have the decorum of the committee.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
We cannot be exchanging like this. And you want us, people to think we are serious.
But sir, you're not serious.
Sure. You don't want me to ask you questions.
No. You are asking.
Sir, Honorable Sarah and Honorable Namuganza, let's have the decorum and keep the decorum.
The committee questioned Namuganza on where she got the mandate as a minister to give out government land. It is alleged that the minister used influence peddling and recommended two beneficiaries, Anil Damani and Seven Hills at Uganda Land Commission, to be allocated land.
Anil Damani, Seven Hills, or Princeton? Is there any from the president?
Have you seen me recommending that the president said give a nil?
Maybe if
Honorable was Chair. Reading my letter, and it is clear, it is here, we can repeat it.
Chair, maybe
I was
can.
Also, he said, I was saying that also these requests were made.
At that time when you were discussing the constructions at Naguru,
you were in cabinet, and yes. I can remind you what the president
seized.
Said.
I had seized. Because your letter is 8th February 2022. I wasn't there.
Okay, let's raise that. Let's
and just
proceed.
A small thing, Chair. I just also want to indicate
the issue of Naguru
that when I was a minister, I would focus on policy issues, and I only intervene in the Ministry of Minerals where there are conflicts. I would never write to the licensing commissioner.
You remember, they accuse you seriously.
Wait. You can make your allegations.
To the extent that the person in charge of operation was secretary.
No, it is okay.
Wrote to you a third
I can. It is okay.
But I think. I
cannot write to the commissioner. I could never write to the commissioner to issue a license.
For me, my letter.
An exploration license.
Can never
let's
be
like any company. Honorable Minister, let's have decorum. Let's have decorum.
But you are allowing
no,
me
no,
to
no,
have
no,
your
no, 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 no.
Can you protect
you
all
can,
of us
can
here?
You can respond. You can respond.
Protect all of
but
us.
You cannot
but
exchange
sir,
as if you are fetching water.
Colleagues, as if.
Committee members accused Namuganza of smuggling Anil Damani and Seven Hills into the presidential directive, which located land to Internal Medicine, Virginia. The minister busted in the committee and traded insults with the former Minister of State for Minerals, Sarah Opendi, who was putting her on the spot.
This is what I'm asking, as per their letter. Which letter you have attached? Mr. Damani denied knowledge of this letter, and that was not his signature. The person you purport to have written for denied knowledge of that letter and even the signature. Honorable Minister, if a person has applied to Uganda Land Commission, I don't know whether this Seven Hills had indicated to you, an application is dated 8th January 2020, already to the commission. But the minister still writes a cover letter to the commission on 24th January 2020. I don't know how I'm supposed to perceive that.
It's also a crime that people have come to you. For you, when you were Minister of State for Minerals, why did you write so many letters?
I wrote.
When it came to Artisan Miner.
No. I wrote letters, but go and
you
check.
Wrote so many letters?
Yes.
Even up
to ministry.
We write letters.
You see.
Can I complete?
No. You first listen. You see, I'm trying to, as much as possible, be fair and constrained. But this throwing of words as if we're for fetching water realities, it's uncalled for.
It was brought by
I have asked you whether there is a presidential directive. And it is easy. You say it is there or it's not there. So this throwing, you can also be directed. It's not my time to be directed. It's your time to be directed.
I was like, when people write to the president, sometimes PPS writes to us, communicating.
Namganza denied ever asking ULC to allocate land to any company, saying that the public is ignorant of the role of the Uganda Land Commission and the Ores end up looking for the ministers. She informed the committee that when the public approaches her, she forwards their requests to the commission.
What I request to them is that they retrieve information which is necessary as per their investigation, but they should allow development to take place. For example, the Uganda Heart Institute informed His Excellency the President they were ready with the money, but they were being constrained from starting to construct. The same to the Virginia Hospital. And also these other developers whom they had allocated land. I appeal to the committee, let people be handled properly.
However, the committee chairperson, Dana Atwijukire, asked the minister to adduce evidence of the said presidential directives on which she acted to recommend allocations of the Naguru Nakawa land.
Okupa, without, because we shall ping pong the whole day, let Honorable Namuganza, in that specific regard, bring us the presidential directives against which she acted. Two, let her bring us the forwardings she has done to ULC.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.